Peter Ramsey, a life like no other. Peter Ramsey was born December 23, 1962 in Crenshaw, Los Angeles, California. He graduated from Pali High at age 17. He then went to college where his animation career began.
I think college is what really sparked Peter's animation career. He enrolled in UCLA where he studied painting for 2 years. He then registered for film classes, furthermore jump-starting his career in animation. He later worked for 26 films, including popular movies like Predator 2, Backdraft, Independence Day, and Fight Club, each movie bringing up different challenges, all of which Peter Ramsey overcame. After dipping his toes in the industry, he decided to join yet another popular movie. At first uninterested, he would join the short film Shrek the Halls as a story artist. This dug a path for future award-winning movies and was a stepping stone for future motion pictures at DreamWorks. This interview by Sarah O'Connell explains his time working for Shrek the Halls.
On that, before they asked me to come in and help on Shrek the Halls, and that was just a, you know, sometimes you see people, you see credits for films, and Shrek the Halls, I'd be surprised if I worked on that more than 2 weeks.
Right.
You know, so it was, but there was, I was jumping around doing all kinds of stuff at DreamWorks during that time, and they were, they kind of started like giving me things to kind of put me on a track toward directing something there.
Dozens of movies over the years led to Rise of the Guardians, Peter Ramsey's biggest film yet.
Here we go!
Everyone loves this
land.
The success continued to 2018, the year Peter co-directed Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. Later announced the 2019 Academy Award for Best Animated Feature.
If that movie had been, like with Spider-Verse, okay, we won an Oscar, but I can't stand here and say, I did it all, it's all because of me. There's no way I can say that, you know? I was part of a team, I was part of a process, and there's other things outside of that. It's the way that other people react to it that also make that possible. So it's the same thing on the other side, you know? It's like, you can't, the failure, sure, maybe you contribute to it or, you know, whatever, but it's not always, and it usually isn't all because of you.
What is it that's going to make him speak to kids and audiences in general right now? Because comic book fans know Miles really well. He's beloved by virtually all the comic fans who saw him sort of come up alongside Peter Parker as a new Spider-Man. But the movie-going audience at large really doesn't know that much about him, doesn't know that much about this whole idea of Spider-Verse. So we wanted to really make people fall in love with him and really make people sort of see that it doesn't matter who's behind the mask.